Solomon Kamja. I'm out here for Your World News. And I just feel it's our responsibility, Your World News, what we are as a media collective that espouses the interests of black and brown communities throughout the United States of America, especially because black and brown communities in the U.S. are historically and systematically oppressed and marginalized. And this is an indication of one of the things that we firmly stand behind, and that is with Brother Troy Davis. You know, this brother has had seven people that initially said that, you know, they witnessed him, you know, commit the murder in Georgia. They've recanted their position. There is considerable reasonable doubt that he did not commit that crime. And the fact of the matter that he is still on the verge of possibly being executed next week means that all of us, especially those of us that are black and brown skinned, we have to stand up for this. First and foremost, we have to fight on behalf of this brother, because this is an injustice. And we know that innocent people have been executed before in America. America, that's one of the things America does. It kills black and brown skinned people at a furious rate. A furious rate, not just on the execution slab, but also through economic policies that are set in place to marginalize and to oppress black and brown skinned people historically in this country. And so we're here, Your World News, we're here in solidarity with our brothers and sisters, you know, across the country, and any liberation-oriented person that is willing to stand up and fight for Troy Davis, as well as all of the other injustices that continue to reign terror and hell upon communities of color throughout the U.S. And we see these injustices raining hell in places like Afghanistan, Iraq, Pakistan, and Libya, and even in Yemen, where the U.S. continues to rain bombs after bombs and indiscriminate missile after missile on these communities. So I'm here with my brothers, Aaron, Rim McGrew, Nisa, and all the other brothers and sisters who are out here right now and are starting to congregate at this flagpole on the campus of Howard University on the yard. And we're going to continue to fight on. That's what Your World News is, because at Your World News, journalism and activism are not mutually exclusive. So we're going to continue to fight on. It's our duty. Thank you.
So many people are flooding their office with calls. Don't let Troy Anthony Davis die on Wednesday because you did nothing. Because all you have to do is get a sheet, get the number, call into the Georgia State Bureau of Prison and Parole, sign the Amnesty International petition, the NAACP petitions, do whatever you have to do to raise awareness, tell your friends, get on Facebook, text people, let them know that the struggle to save Troy Davis's life is on right now, and it's crucial. You got till Wednesday to save his life. Till Wednesday, and that's it. He'll be executed Wednesday night.
Our organization, our name is Students Against Mass Incarceration. We do things like this. We raise awareness around the prison industrial complex, political prisoners, issues, the fact that there are people who are still incarcerated from the Black Panther Party and other organizations, the fact that there is a prison for profit industry in this country. And this is a part of that process of raising awareness. As I was telling the sister here, many people just raising awareness, beginning the process of education, because many of our people still think that slavery is illegal. It was abolished 150 years ago, right? No, slavery is still legal in the United States. It was the 13th Amendment clearly states that voluntary servitude is abolished except in cases of punishment for a crime. People don't know that there was a counterintelligence program in this country to repress, to disrupt, discredit, and otherwise neutralize black nationalist hate type organizations, end quote. That they don't know about these things. They really raise awareness about this case, to really make the connections between this and others, the fact that this is a racist, not only just a racist, but fundamentally the United States government is a white supremacist organization. And we have to see it that way in terms of understanding and make the connections between our movements and others and the anti-immigrant movement and all of these issues, and really just raise awareness around this case, the fact that this is a racist criminal justice system, so-called justice system.
This piece I'm about to do is a political piece. It's called Yes We Can. Can we address the matter at hand? Too many black brothers in the corner in the van. And the narcotics so in demand, seem like the world is high. Nobody coming down again. Listen, we need a detox early before it's too late. It's a state of emergency every single state. Bloods and Crips banging, miners on strips hanging, police locking us up with a weed cane and judge giving run-on sentences. That's bad grammar. A lot of questions true, no real answers. What happened to black power? You remember Black Panthers? I shorty getting her degree, but she's a lap dancer. They making cures for sex, but what about cancer? I'm surrounded by garbage. I feel like Fred Sanford. Change is imminent and so in demand. And the only thing left to say is yes, we can. Put your fist up on each and every hand. Every boy, every girl, every woman, every man. If you sit and take a stand, the future's in plan. Say yes, we can. It's so, so depressing. The world's in a recession. I mean, times is hard. Everybody got questions. Vexed on a quest in a random direction. Seeing money, still can't seem to make a connection. Generation X every night, mom's stressing. Looking in her kids' room, always checking. Baby's having babies, shorty didn't use protection. Son got killed because he gave up that confession. Pop killed the corporate and he got lethal injection. It's so hard to swallow, sort of like indigestion. Life for life, it's a sad, sad lesson. You live past 25. Count your blessings. Whatever don't kill you, make you stronger. It's not about your gender, nor your genre, not even your complexion. Local or foreigner, it's about getting your foot in before they close the door on you. Say yes, we can. Put your fist up on each and every hand. Every boy, every girl, every woman, every man. If you sit and take a stand, the future's in our hands. Say yes, we can.
Why are you in solidarity with Troy Davis and out here on the campus of Howard University in protest of the possible execution of this brother in Georgia?
Well, first, I'm down to support any effort to help any of those who are unjustly incarcerated, who try to raise critical focus around mass incarceration as an issue. Troy Davis represents not only each of us as individuals, but he represents the larger problem facing not only society, particularly the relationship of the state to its black or colonized African population. So Troy is all of us. We should be out here doing at least the bare minimum that we are doing to support his, if not freedom, certainly the stay of execution, and then ultimately, hopefully, a retrial where all the evidence that is so clear will be put back on the table, and then he could be let go. And then this issue could then be used to refocus on the many others who are in his similar condition, and then more broadly speaking, all the people who are locked up in a system that is ultimately unjust in and of itself. So that's why I'm here, to do my little part and support those who put this together. And it's an honor.
To see you asking questions, wondering what this is all about. This is so important to me because at one time in my life, I was your age.
Where are you doing it at?
The reason why this is important to me is because I was Troy Davis. I was convicted in a system designed to fail. It is so very important to you because one day, Troy Davis may be you. I care about you. I have 6 nieces and nephews. I have 8 grandchildren. And one day, this may be them. It is important because some of you are studying to become lawyers. There are men and women who have been accused of crimes and they cannot defend themselves because of a system designed to fail. And they need you, your mind, your intellect, your passion, to defend them from people who are executing a war on us.
Why are you in support of Troy Davis? Why are you out here at this rally on the campus of Howard University to protest the possible execution of a black man by the name of Troy Davis in Georgia?
I'm here partly for myself because whatever happens to him could very well happen to me or anybody else of my color, that color. And just me coming here right now to just protest for him and to stand on his behalf, it's one step forward to progress, I think. And the whole fact is that he is not proven guilty beyond the fact. There are serious doubts that he is innocent. And the whole fact is that there's a chance that they can reopen the case and just investigate like they should have done in the first place and just give him his freedom, or at least just give him a chance to appeal his case. And I'm just here just to support that he should, get that chance.
Hundreds of Troy Davises all across this country, trapped on death row, trapped in prison, innocent of their crimes, people who want to come back and contribute to their communities, who are being discriminated against, who are being turned into second-class citizens strictly because of who they are. A system that targets the poor, the working class, the black, and we know all of those things running together in this society. system, a police state, and a criminal justice system that is stacked against those same people.
16, 2011 on the campus of Howard University for a rally in support of Troy Davis, a brother in Atlanta, Georgia, who is slated to be executed next week. And there's considerable reasonable doubt that he did not commit the murder that they say he did. And I just want to ask you, why are you out here in solidarity to protest the execution, the possible execution of Brother Troy Davis in Georgia?
I mean, I think it's our responsibility. It could quite easily be me, one of my brothers, any family member or friend that could be in this position right now. I'm out here in support of Troy to bring exposure to his case. I'm out here representing my fraternity, Malik Fraternity Incorporated. But more importantly, I'm out here representing black men. Out here to be a voice for him when he can't be a voice for himself, and hopefully bring more exposure for more people to voice their opinion on what the matter is.
Are you willing to fight on and continue to speak out against these kind of injustices that seem to continuously disproportionately affect black people in America as opposed to their so-called white counterparts?
I'm gonna be the fight out here, man. I'm a product of this whole situation, and for me to sit back and watch it happen is more of a help for the problem than it is a solution. I'm not gonna sit back and watch this. We can't just keep watching our people get killed off like this. We're getting killed off at alarming rates, and we're just watching it because we don't get the exposure on mainstream media about cases like this. If it was a white little boy, a white little girl out there, and this a stray bullet goes through their house and strikes that little white kid, it's gonna be all over the news. But they're showing us right now that our value as a black man is more dead than alive.
Right.
And we're just sitting back and watching it happen. Most cases than not, we get the information about cases like this after the fact. We don't get it while it's going on. And that's on purpose, because they don't want us to be exposed to the things that are happening in our communities. The more exposure that it gains, the more people that know about it, the more that we're going to raise noise and they can't ignore it and sweep it under the rug. So yeah, you damn right I'm going to be out here.
Right on, right on.